I wanted also to talk about the attack that was pushed towards Kalonzo Musyoka yesterday by one Ruto, deputy president of this country, about the Yatta land that I can say here Kalonzo owns it, and he acquired it very regularly and very legally. As a former minister of lands, I checked the details of that land, and I found that actually Kalonzo had acquired that land very well. So I would like to tell Deputy President Ruto to stop thinking that somebody of Kalonzo's stature and standing can do the kind of things he himself does when he sees any empty piece of land anywhere. And to say that the attack on Kalonzo was very ill-conceived, I think each and every Kenyan, even birds of the air, can tell the biggest land grabber in this country, if not in the world, and that is Ruto himself. We all know that Ruto does not see any empty piece of land anywhere, and even any land that is occupied, and he does not go for it. I'll give you an instance. I was the Minister of Land, and the worst that I saw Ruto trying to do was to grab the piece of land that belonged to Langata Primary School next to his Western Hotel. Poor children's land that he himself thought it wise to grab it, to own it, to even bring askaris to tear gas poor children who come from the slums and who have nowhere to live, who have nowhere to play. I do pray and hope that Ruto will never be in a position where he can do that kind of a thing again. Only recently we saw Ruto grab Siwa, Cho. He grabs everything. He has grabbed Cho. He has grabbed processional way. We know that he is the same man. Ruto has had many cases in court. He even grabbed late Muteshi's land. This man cannot be coming from his mouth that he can talk like this.